Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is time to take a break from your Black Friday shopping and catch up on all the major news from the Disney parks. 2021 is going to be a big year, and these updates will definitely affect your trip. Stay tuned. To another edition of Disney Parks News Roundup on All Ears TV. I'm Margot Jordan, here to bring you the latest. Starting January 1st, 2021, things are going to be a whole lot different in Disney World. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. We have updates on so many ongoing projects that'll be opening in 2021 and beyond, info on a new way to get to Disney World, and updates on the West Coast where you can once again step inside a Disney theme park. Let's get cracking. First up, park hopping is coming back. Park hopping has been suspended at Disney World since the parks reopened. You can currently only visit one park per day, and you must reserve a park pass in advance to enter the park. But things are changing. Starting January 1st, 2021, park hopping will return. Disney has stated that guests who have purchased a ticket or annual pass with park hopper benefits will be able to visit more than one park per day after 2 p.m. The Disney World website will continue to update these hours as they could start earlier at a later date, depending on the day and park. You'll still need to make a park pass reservation for the first park you intend to visit each day and actually visit that park before you can hop to another. Disney has stated that park pass reservations for the second park guests may visit are not required during this time, but hopping will depend on park capacity limits, which, in case you missed it, Disney World has now increased park capacity to 35%, up from 25%. These changes to the park hopper system aren't majorly different, but they will affect your visit to Disney's Hollywood Studios. Disney has noted that guests who choose Disney's Hollywood Studios as their second park of the day will not be able to join the virtual queue at Rise of the Resistance. Park-to-park transportation will be returning in 2021 as well. We should have more details on exactly which type soon. Second on the news roundup, Remy's Ratatouille Adventure is opening in 2021. We have more good news for your 2021 trip. Remy's Ratatouille Adventure will be opening in Epcot's France Pavilion sometime in 2021. We're still awaiting an official opening date, but we now know this new ride will be coming sometime next year. Also opening next year, La Crêperie de Paris, a quick service and table service combo restaurant that's also in the France Pavilion. And that's not all. We've got even more updates on Epcot projects straight from the Imagineers who are working on them. We got a peek of the ride vehicles on the actual track of Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind, which will also be opening in Epcot in 2021. Epcot's new, coming soon fireworks show, Harmony Us, is still in the works. 5 floating platforms positioned like a compass will house the primary show equipment. The central piece will be a whopping 6 stories tall, and there will be 8 54-foot moving arms. Those platforms will act as a fountain in the center of World Showcase Lagoon during the day. What a spectacle that's gonna be! Spaceship Earth may not be undergoing that major refurb to change up the ride itself just yet, but there will be new projections on the outside of the geodesic dome that will further integrate it into the new design for the front of the park. We also got a quick glimpse inside Space 220, the space-themed restaurant that will simulate dining at a space station, which is due to open in 2021 as well. That's not all that's happening, you guys. We've learned that the refurb of Splash Mountain, making it a Princess and the Frog-themed ride, has been moved to the top of Disney's to-do list, and the project has been expedited. There's still no word on what the time frame may be, but we should be hearing more soon. We also got a peek at one of the hotel rooms at the Star Wars Hotel. And it is out of this world! This totally immersive 2-day experience, it is not just a stay at a hotel, y'all, is due to open in 2021. If it's on your Disney bucket list to be one of the first to stay at this brand new hotel concept, stick with us here at All Ears TV because we will let you know as soon as booking opens. It is sure to be popular. While we're on the topic of Disney World hotels, guests at the Grand Floridian now have one more way to get to the Magic Kingdom. Disney World has just opened a walking path that connects the Grand Floridian Resort to the park entrance at the Magic Kingdom. The walk will take around 15 to 20 minutes, which can be a big time saver if resort transportation lines are long. Brightline has recently been in talks about bringing a high-speed train to Disney World that would connect it to other stops, including the Orlando International Airport and Miami. Well, get excited because Brightline has now confirmed that it will actually be adding a high-speed rail station to Disney Springs. The finer details are still being ironed out, but it looks like we may soon have a new way to get to Disney World. Let's move on to some restaurant reopenings. Disney World is still moving along with their phased reopening, and we can once again dine at several fan favorite restaurants. Harambe Market in Animal Kingdom has reopened, as has Woody's Lunchbox in Hollywood Studios. Crystal Palace in Magic Kingdom will reopen on December 13th, though there will be no characters at this time, and the meal will be served family style rather than the restaurant's usual buffet. Plus, Tomorrowland Terrace will reopen in Magic Kingdom on December 17th, offering another outdoor dining location in the park. Buena Vista Street inside Disney California Adventure has opened for shopping and dining, meaning that we can once again get some delicious corn dogs and enjoy a drink at the Carthay Circle Lounge. You will likely need to join a virtual waitlist to enter Buena Vista Street. Mobile order or walk-up waitlists for dining are only available to guests who are already inside the park. These won't grant you access if Buena Vista Street is at capacity. But overall, wait times don't seem to be too long, and it's so nice to get inside a Disney park on the West Coast, even if there are no rides just yet. I'm pumped. What a bummer! Disney Cruise Line has once again suspended sailings, this time all the way through January 2021. Guests are able to receive a future cruise credit or full refund if they have paid in full, or a partial refund of what they've paid so far. We'll keep an ear out for upcoming February sailing dates. Oh, and we've recently gotten some updates on new Disney tech that may change your vacation experience. First up, let's talk about Disney Genie. Disney's goal for Genie is to make planning and enjoying a vacation at our parks stress-free. From the brief preview we saw, it appears as though you can make and change your plans throughout the day based on your preferences as well as Disney's recommendations based on attraction type, location, wait times, etc. These all add up to a customizable itinerary on your smart device with ease. Disney is also integrating tech into their storytelling within the parks. The goal is to enhance storytelling with digital, data, and interactive features that go far beyond what they've achieved in the past. Disney began storytelling in a linear fashion, displaying the story right in front of you. This was used on attractions like Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room. The next step is using interactive storytelling, much like the experiences guests have on Toy Story Mania. Then there is immersive storytelling, which we've seen used in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge and the Play Disney Parks app. The final step is personalized and social storytelling, what we'll see at the Star Wars Hotel. Personalization and socialization storytelling will be accessible from guests' phones and wearables. Disney will continue to use augmented reality and artificial intelligence to enhance guest experiences inside and outside the parks to expand storytelling and further engage their guests, including a new VR experience at Animal Kingdom that will get guests closer to the animals than ever before. Far out! Wow, what a day for Disney Parks news, huh? What tidbit today are you most excited about? Tell us in the comments. Oh, and be sure to check back here for Molly's trip to Epcot's Festival of the Holidays, which starts today. I'm Margo Jordan, and thanks for trusting us as your go-to source for all things Disney destinations. Bye for now!